You guys, you're watching Surgery Secrets. Before I get started with today's video, I'm filming a video every single day until further notice, so if you have any video requests, definitely leave them down below. So any video requests will be greatly appreciated. Other than that, let's get started with today's video, and all the links for everything will be in the description box, and also follow me on Instagram, it's Sergio Secreto, so if you could follow me, that really means a lot to me, and subscribe as well. Today's requested video was a sunglass video. So for me, I'm somebody that loves sunglasses. I wear sunglasses everywhere. If you've seen a lot of my pictures, I'm always photographed in sunglasses. I just like that I can be a different person, like just, I don't know, something about sunglasses I just really like. It makes me feel super confident. It protects my eyes. At the end of the day, I live in Texas, so, you know, being outside in the sun, you know, I do really need some protection to have some that are polarized, some that are not polarized. It's just for me, I think I love a sunglass even more than certain other accessories. It's just a sunglass is you can just hide and you can be who you want to be. And I've always loved sunglasses as a child. I think my first accessory was like a Ray-Ban. So guys, I have exactly 20 pairs of glasses to show you. They're all going to be ranging from Ray-Ban up to more designer pairs. I know I'm probably going to get questions for glasses that are under $100. So I'm going to quickly talk about Key, Lease, and brands like that. So Key Australia, I used to have Key glasses. I no longer wear Key glasses. I think some of them are cute, some of them are nice, but I have other glasses that I'd rather wear that I spent my hard-earned money on. So I don't really wear a lot of Key glasses anymore. My mom is a big fan. She wears a lot of my older Key glasses, and she has purchased newer glasses like the Jennifer Lopez collection. She loves them. Lee Specs, I've had Lee Specs in the past as well. But like I said, probably one of my most favorite brands of glasses that are under $100 are going to be Diff. I just think the Diff ones are really nice. They're really substantial. I don't own any pairs, but I've seen them, I've held them, I played with them, I see people wear them, and for me, I just really like Diff, and I think all the glasses are $85. So if you really want a nice glass under $100, I would say Diff. I really, really like the quality of Diff. Let's go ahead and get started with my sunglass collection. So I'm going to be going in by brand. So I'll do Ray-Ban, and then we'll kind of go from there. So for Ray-Ban, like I said, it is my first brand of glasses that I've had. So Ray-Ban just means a lot to me. I just feel like a lot of the styles are very clean cut classic. You can never go wrong. So the first one's gonna be the OG Aviator. This actually kind of goes with my outfit because I'm wearing this little green army jacket that I ordered today. Nordstrom Rack has like a lot of great deals. And this one was Retail Good American and it was literally 80% off. So I got it for like $22 or $23. Such a great deal. It's nice and cropped. And they just kind of happen to go with my outfits. These are the original, these are 58s. The Ray-Ban Aviators come in three sizes. There's a small, medium, and large. Well, technically four because there is a junior's version of it, like a kid's. But I like these. I don't wear these as much. As you can see, they touch my cheeks, so that does bother me. But these are probably one of the, this is the oldest sunglass that I have in my collection. They're very kind of clean-cut classic. I do pull them out for certain outfits, but I don't really wear them as much just because they do hit my cheek. Here are another pair of Ray-Bans right here. Now, these ones, my aunt gave them to me, and I believe they were my grandpa's. As you can see, like, they are, like, straight-up vintage Ray-Ban glasses. I think they're pretty cool. They're pretty nice. I would never get rid of them. I don't really wear them just because, you know, I feel like they don't really go with my face shape really well, but they are vintage and they were a gift and I really appreciate it because she didn't have to give me these pair of glasses, but I really do like them. When I did get them about like 2 or 3 years ago, I did wear them for a little bit, but now they're just an archive in my collection. Who knows, I may pull them out for a certain outfit, but I really do like and I appreciate her for giving me these Ray-Bans. These ones that I have here are going to be a, I believe that this is a plastic lens, so that's why these glasses are super lightweight. They have more of that circle, a flat lens. They look very modern. They look very kind of fresh, very new. I like these a lot. Super lightweight. When I wear them, I don't feel like anything. They're going to be the little circle ones that I have. I think they're really cute. I don't really wear these as much because I have another pair of circle ones, which I'll show you next. But I do really like these a lot. And, you know, I just think that they're a good lightweight glass. This is the one that I wear the most out of all my Ray-Bans. They're going to be these. They are a circle. I got these at the Nordstrom Anniversary Sale in 2018. They're polarized. As you can see, kind of like some of the color has like went off because I've dropped them and stuff. I'm glad that I haven't shattered these or anything like that. But these are my favorite Ray-Bans. They're just clean cut classic. They're made out of glass. They're a little bit more heavy. They're a little bit more substantial. They're a flat lens. They're polarized. They're very modern. They're just very much my style. And I just really like them a lot. like I said, they're black. This is like literally me in a sunglass. If I were to create a circle glass, it would be like, and like I said, with the circle trend, I have another pair of Ray-Bans, and they are these. I believe I got these at the Nordstrom anniversary sale last year, and they are polarized. They are blue. They're a little bit more see-through. You can kind of get away with wearing them indoors. I don't try to wear glasses indoors just because I feel like it's not always appropriate, but I do sometimes from time to time. If I'm like going to go to Starbucks to pick up my order and then just go back to my car, I would just leave them on. But for the most part, I do take them off. But I like these. You can see my eyes a little bit better. Not as much by the lights, but if you're like out and about with the sunlight, you can really see my eyes through them. They're polarized, which is really nice because they're such a light lens. So for them to be polarized is really great. I really like them. I like the blue lens. Blue and green are basically my favorite colors, but for sure blue. And you know, when I saw these at the anniversary sale, I was like, I have to have them. And they're gorgeous and they're really nice, and I'm happy that I have them in my collection. The pair of Ray-Bans that I have are the Ray-Ban Ericas. The Ray-Ban Ericas is a nice sporty pair. These I exclusively wear to the gym. These are my gym glasses. These are always in my gym bag right here. The gym bag that I've been using very recently is my Dagny Dover. I love it so much. I have a Dagny Dover review video, so if you want to see it, it'll be linked down below. But for me, I love the keyhole. They're nice and lightweight. If I drop them, they're just very kind of heavy-duty glasses. And for me, these are like my absolute gym glasses. Like after I leave the gym or when I'm going to the gym, these are the glasses that I kind of go for. They've been used. They look pretty beat up, but like there's like literally, I mean, there's a little scratch right here because I did drop them one time, but other than that, they look good. And like I said, these are my gym glasses and I really like them. And if I'm out and about, these are the glasses that I'm going to be wearing and take a little bit more of a beating. My Ray-Ban Ericas, they also come in brown, and they come in a polarized version and the brown version as. I would highly suggest the Ericas. I would highly suggest the circle ones because those are my favorite Ray-Ban glasses in my collection. Let's go ahead and go with Celine. So these are my Celine white glasses. I think I told you guys the story. I bought these at Nordstrom Rack. Basically, they are a little stretched out, so I have to go in. Actually, I think after this video, I'm gonna get my blow dryer, and I'm just literally gonna blow them dry, because whenever you heat up the acetate, I wouldn't recommend doing this at home. I would definitely take it to a professional. Do is you just heat this up, and I'm just gonna bring it in more forward, so the glasses fit a lot better, and so they don't look like they're kind of sticking out, but I do really like them. They're really cool. I bought these because they kind of give me like the Louis Vuitton and Millionaire glasses vibes, the ones that like J Balvin and a lot of people wear. I saw those at the Heathrow Airport when I was in London, and I kind of regret not buying them because I really do like them. I'm not the biggest LB fan, but I do really like those glasses, and these, when I bought these last year around the summertime, they kind of gave me those vibes. So I'm definitely going to adjust these, but once I adjust these are going to be a pair of glasses that I'm going to be wearing all the time, and I think Celine makes really decent glasses. Yeah, Celine pair. These are the first ones that I got in high school. Got these my going into my junior year of high school. I bought these during the summertime, and they are the Talias, Atelias. I no longer really wear these. I honestly think I'm just gonna give them away to one of my friends. Just because I don't know, I've just worn these a lot. They've been in my collection forever, and I'm kind of over this style and over this shape. I have other glasses that I wear a little bit more, but like I said, when I had them, I did use them. I did like them. There's another version of these that are flat lens that have nose pieces. They're called like the Kim glasses. But these are were my first Celines. I liked them a lot, but I just think I kind of fell out of love with them. Final Celine are going to be these ones right here. These are kind of like the superstar glasses. These ones are still available, which I'll leave linked down below. I featured this in one of my videos, are luxury items that I thought I was gonna love and use when I bought, and I like these a lot. They're definitely more of a statement, but they're definitely like a head turner, like, oh my god, like, who is he? Who does she think he is? Like, you know, stuff like that. So I wore them a lot when I first got them back in September, but I definitely haven't worn them that much. I'm still kind of mixed feelings about this. I know I got a lot of DMs telling you guys that they do look good on me, but I think I'm ultimately going to keep them. But what do you guys think about these Celines? Do you think they're a little bit, I know they're over a little bit too much, but are they like a little bit of a try hard glass? Because if it does represent that try too hard, I definitely don't want to wear them. But they're kind of sleek, they're more of a conversation, they're like, oh my god, like, these are such like a vibe to have. They're gonna be my final Celines, and si son bonitas, si me gustan mucho, pero no sé, creo que es poquito too much for my style. We're gonna go ahead and do Tom Ford. I have three glasses from Tom Ford. I have these ones right here, and these ones are the Alyssa. My mom has these in the tortoise shell. I think I featured these in one of my videos before, and I got both of them, and I gave my mom the tortoise shell ones. I have the black ones, and I just think it's so cute that me and my mom have little matching Tom Ford glasses. Hers are tortoise, mine's are black, and if we want to share, we can definitely can, because they're the exact same glass. These kind of, I don't know, I like them because they don't really show my eyebrow. They're definitely more of a feminine gloss. I've wore these a handful of times. I do really like them. They don't really touch my cheeks, and I just think Tom Ford makes really great products, and I really do like a lot of their glosses, and these kind of give me kind of like Ray-Ban Clubmaster vibe. Top favorite glasses. I actually lost these glasses. I've lost in a few pairs of glasses throughout the años, pero perdí estas. Yo creo que estaba haciendo de compras, and I probably left them in the counter, and I forgot what store, because usually, like, I'm always all over the place. My stuff is all over the place, and sometimes I don't notice if stuff are missing or stuff is this. I didn't know I lost them, because I always thought, oh, they're somewhere, and I really did lose them, and I missed them so much that I repurchased them. Yeah, these are the Tom Ford Pias. They're kind of like that Celine vibe, but they're a little bit more square like that versus more square like this. And I like that they don't touch my cheeks. I like that they're nice oversized. I love the flat lens. They're very modern, oversized. There's just kind of a glass that I'm looking for, and I get a lot of compliments on them. I just think they're very kind of clean cut, and yeah, they're just kind of a fun, oversized, classic pair of glasses that you can kind of never go wrong with. And like I said, los pierdi, and I honestly love them so much that I had to rebuy them, and lloré poquito. I'm not gonna lie, I had to put the glasses back on once I bought them because I shedded a little tear because I lost them. Tom Ford Pias are definitely one of my favorite glasses. And then the last ones that I have are these men's ones. They're polarized. These are the newer edition. I got these literally the day after I came back from London, about a month and a half ago. And I just really like them. They are very lightweight. They're polarized. They work for my style really well. I think they would go well with this outfit. I love that I can wear suits. I can wear shorts. I just feel like these glasses are very universal and very appropriate for all the occasions that I have to do. And these are a very reliable pair of glasses that I'm happy that I have in my collection. And yeah, I could not be happier. And I think out of this one and the Pia, I think this year these are probably going to be one of my top three worn glasses. And yeah, these Tom Ford men's, I just love them. They make me feel like so elevated. They're polarized. For me, polarization, they help out with glare. I do drive a lot. I love to drive. I love to film videos. I drive a lot to, you know, do certain things. So for me, having polarized, I do prioritize it. It's not necessarily a killer. If it doesn't have it and I like them, I will still buy them. But if there is a polarized version, because I know like Tom Ford and other brands like Ray-Ban, they have a polarized and a non-polarized, I would definitely always go more for the polarized version, just because I feel like, for me, it is worth having a polarization in a lens. That we're gonna go into, and then we'll go into the off ones, are gonna be Maui Jim. So I added these two Maui Jims into my collection about a week ago. The reason why I went for Maui Jims is because they're all polarized. They'll have polarized plus two. I talked about this in one of my vlogs where I actually went to Dillard's and I showed you all some of the Maui Jim glasses. I'll leave that video linked down below. And I told you guys that Maui Jim glasses are probably the best glasses, and they have the best customer service as well. So if you don't know, Luxottica and Safilo and like other brands, they make a lot of the other glasses. So Ray-Ban, they make Chanel glasses. They make Prada glasses, they make Burberry, they make Ralph Lauren, Valentino, Tiffany. They are just kind of like a subdivision, and they just make so many different brands. And Safilo makes Fendi, they make Dior. They just make a lot of different brands of glasses. So Maui Jim is independently owned by themselves. They do everything, and they have the best quality service and on hand on, well, like throughout my eyes. And I just feel like me having Maui Jim glasses, and throughout my channel I talk about having quality versus quantity, having things that last or are made really well. So just me having Maui Jim glasses in my collection, which is kind of a must, and it's just kind of a relationship that I just wanted to have. Like, I wanted to have Maui Jim glasses. My uncle has a few pair of Maui Jim glasses, and I'd always steal them from his, and I'm finally happy that now I went and I bought these glasses for myself. So these are kind of the OG Clubmasters. I've always wanted an OG Clubmasters, but the thing is, they're not as like, they don't touch my cheeks as like the original Clubmasters. They're a little bit more square, which I like. And yeah, these are just a very kind of casual pair of glasses. I like them. I love the polarized, and I like that a lot of the Maui Jims going forward, they look a lot more fashion forward versus them looking more traditional. And kind of same for Ray-Ban. I think Ray-Ban had like a lot of traditional glasses, and I like that they're doing more kind of fashion forward styles. And then the other one, which are my favorite, because now I have a pair of aviators. I've been wanting a nice pair of aviators that do not touch my cheek, that look good, that make me feel awesome. And I finally found them. Like I said, a lot of Ray-Bans and a lot of the other brands, I just don't like the color, the style, the fit, how heaviness, and these ones are very lightweight. They're titanium, polarized plus two. I love the color of the lens. They even go with this outfit, like the OG Ray-Ban aviators, and I just really like them, and I'm happy I wear into my collection. I definitely see myself having more, and I definitely see myself talking more quality versus quantity on my channel, just because I always prefer and I'd rather invest in having the higher quality item, that one nice thing that I will love and appreciate more. So for Maui Jim, that kind of goes hand on hand with my beliefs and how they treat their customers like that. So Maui Jim aviators, I definitely do really like, and I'm so happy that I now have a pair of clean cut classic aviators that are polarized and titanium because they're so lightweight. When with the off brands, these are going to be glasses that I have one of. So these are my one and only Gucci glasses. They are a men's tortoiseshell. I don't really wear these as much. I don't think on me. I may have to give these to my little brother or the guys in my family. I just think that they're a little bit too big on me. I've only worn these like two times. So these Gucci glasses, I think I will end up giving to one of the men's in my life. And I do like this little enamel detail right here. And yeah, I like them, but I don't think they're for me per se. The next one is going to be another one of my absolute favorites. I wear these a lot. The only thing I hate about these glasses, I love all Olive Reed people. I want to add more. They're really pricey, but that's not the reason why I hate them. So the reason why I hate them is every single time I put them on, and I think because these are vintage glass, I love Oliver people. I just think they make so many fun styles, but it does not recognize my face. Like, it literally, guys, it does not recognize my face at all. That's the only thing. All the other glasses, even like that is my face, but these ones do not. I like them a lot. They're very clean cut. I love that they have like the little tortoiseshell right here. I love the three dots. They're very minimal. Like a lot of celebrities and a lot of people, like Barack Obama and like a lot of, you know, people, they wear Oliver people because they are elevated, very high quality brand, but they have no branding, no logo. You have to know what these three dots are. Some people think that they're Celine. They're not. They're a little bit more different. And for me, I just like Oliver people a lot, and I see myself purchasing more in the future. They are a little bit more pricey, but I do see myself adding a lot more Oliver people just because they're kind of like me, you know. I like to wear brands, I like to wear logo stuff. I do like that, but for the most part, I do like very kind of minimal, kind of crisp, elevated pieces like Oliver people, Vince and Theory and stuff like that. So Oliver people, I like them, and I'm happy that I've had them in my collection. And I think I've added these ones in I think July or August of last year. Are my little Cholito Cholita glasses. Porque, like, literally, I think it's just because of this detail right here. So I like los lentes estas de aquí. Like, I like the style of them. I'm not the biggest fan of the gold, even though it does look cute in my Instagram picture. Like, I have a picture of wearing these. I just think that these are such a vibe, you know what I mean? These ones you wear with, like, such, you can dress them up, you can dress them down. And I just like how, like, they're statement-y, kind of like the Celine ones that are, like, big and oversized, but they're not as statement-y. And a lot of the Versace glasses, they have more statement, but you know, I really like the shape of these, and I think these are called like the Biggie style. These come in so many colors. I definitely see myself maybe adding the white one or like a blue one or like a fun kind of acetate color, but I do really like these. And yeah, I know my mom was like, she's not me. Yes, I give me mama no le gustan esos lentes, pero a mí sí me gustan esas gafas. I think that they're nice, and I think they work well, and especially if I were to wear it with this Veronica Beard blazer right here. Ugh, like these buttons and like the gold right here, like, isn't that such a vibe? And yeah, I just love this Veronica Beard blazer, but I just think that they're just such a vibe if you wear other gold accessories with them. But yeah, these are my one and only Versaces, and regardless of what my mom says, I actually sí me gustan de verdad. I think they're kind of fun. I don't know why. On to the last three. So these ones are a cat eye. These ones are Vera Wang for Kohl's. I used to work at Kohl's when I was 17. If you want to see the story of Tim on that, definitely let me know down below. It taught me a lot of things in the retail industry, and it was my first retail job, and for me, I just really like them a lot. I love the cat eye. I like that they're very lightweight. I don't wear these as much, but I think I bought these as I was departing from Kohl's, and I think I got these like $10 because I had like some Kohl's. This one are a brand new pair of glasses that I haven't even worn. I've actually had these in my closet for like 2 months now, and they still have the tag on them, but I think I'm gonna wear them out any day now. They're lightweight, they're Saint Laurent, they have a green lens, they have more of a lighter tortoiseshell. I have learned that I like tortoiseshell, but I prefer a black acetate a lot more, and I just think they're like a very kind of Wayfairy type style. They're a little bit more thinner, and I feel like they look a little bit more modern than traditional Wayfair. I think they look a little bit more modern than the Wayfair. I definitely do like the Wayfairs. I think they're very they will never go out of anywhere, but these are more of an updated version from Saint Laurent, and I like them a lot. I think they're really cute. I don't know when I'm gonna wear them. Who knows? I may even wear them today, but I like them, and I'm happy that I have them in my collection. And I don't know. They're just a very clean cut, classic style, and a lot of things that you see in my collection are very clean cut, classic, elevated, polished, with a little bit of here and there, kind of like those Versace glasses, those Celine glasses. You have a little bit more statement-y pieces here and there. 20th pair of glasses that I have is going to be these Chanel ones. These are my one and only Chanel. I try to love a lot of Chanel glasses. It's just some of them just look a little too feminine. I'm more of a bigger face, so sometimes they're a little bit more harder to find styles that I like. I do like the ones with the chains. I see myself maybe adding one in the future, but the one and only that I have, I got these about 2 years ago. They are a flat lens, just something that I really like. I do get a lot of compliments every single time I wear them. They have more kind of like this grayish kind of lens on them. They have the silver classic CC. I just think that they're very classic but modern, and you can't see my eyes throughout them. They kind of have more of that square shape. I just really like them a lot, and I try to buy other Chanels, but nothing compares to this one. This is my absolute favorite one. I don't think they make these anymore, but if I can find them, I'll leave them linked down below. But yeah, these are my one and only Chanel glasses. I do really like them. I do get a lot of wear out of them. But yeah, these are gonna be my entire sunglass collection. Like I said, I have about 20 pairs. I have some ones that I really, really like, some of them I don't really wear. And yeah, I prefer higher end glasses. That's just my choice. I'm missing a few pair of glasses. Like, I have a pair of Dior's, a few Ray-Bans, I have a pair of Rag & Bone, and like a few more that I'm missing, maybe 5, but I honestly don't know where they're at. But if I'm gonna be showing you my top 5 currently right now, obviously my first one that I'm gonna have to mention are the circle Ray-Bans with the polarization. I just like these, and these are just a very clean cut style, and I really do enjoy wearing them. Maui Jim Aviators, my new ones made out of titanium. That's gonna be my second favorite that I have. My third one is definitely going to Tom Ford Men's Polarized pair. I just like these a lot. My fourth favorite that I'm currently like kind of obsessed with are going to be my Oliver People. Like I said, ever since I've had these in my collection, oh, same thing, I lost these and they were like literally in the back of my car for like the longest, and I found them, and now like I even appreciate them even more because I did not want to pay $445 to replenish these glasses. Fourth favorite. And my fifth and final favorite glasses that I have currently in my collection is these Versace ones. These were stuck in one of my bags. And like I said, stuff is always all over the place, but these were stuck in one of my bags and I found them. So now I love them again. So they're gonna be my top 5 pair of glasses. I love all the other ones. Are my core, that are my go-to, my Ray-Ban, Maui Jim, Tom Ford, Oliver People, and Versace. And I will be showing you 2 accessories or things that I use to kind of take care of my glasses. So I bought this in one of my videos from Shopping on Dillard's. I think this is $35 on the Key website. If it's on sale, I'll try to find it. But anyway, so I saw this, right? I've been wanting this for a while. And I was like, you know what? I wanted something that can hold on my glasses. So it has 1, 2, 3, 4 places to put those gafas aquí. So I went and I told the cashier, like, oh, I'm ready to check out. And when she scanned it, it was 65% off. So I literally got this for like $14. And then there was like a rose gold one. And I got one too for my mom. We both love glasses. She has an awesome sunglass collection as well. And so I got this one. I really do like it. And what I like is that I can put all my core styles here. And it fits in my Dior book tote. It fits in like a lot of my totes. So for me, it's just nice because I can have a lot of variations. And I do like to change my glasses from time to time. And the way I clean my glasses is I do have like a lot of the microfibers and a lot of cases and stuff, but I do use this little cleanser that I bought on Amazon. And I think when I bought the Oliver Peoples, they came with this kind of picture of Oliver. Oh, these are really pretty. And so what I do is I'll just spray it on here, and I just like literally just clean them up, make sure that they're all good, make sure there's no like little residue or something. I just make sure that they're always clean. I always make sure that my glasses are always clean cut, polished. That's why I did one ahead and purchase this one. So if one is dirty, I can change glasses. But yeah, these are the items that I use. The bigger kind of microfiber from Oliver People. This little clarity lens. And as far as single cases, my favorite single cases that I have are going to be... I actually use a Saint Laurent case more than actual glasses because I haven't worn them. But I like this case because it's very matte, it's sleek, it just fits in every single item. And this Oliver People one I really do like as well. There's other cases that are a little bit more bulky, or it's not what I'm looking for. But these two are my favorite brand of cases that they make, which I really love and appreciate. But yeah, this was a requested video for my sunglass collection / little bit of items, how I take care of them. And yeah, thank you so much for watching my video. I really appreciate you guys taking taking the time to watch my videos. Like I said, I'm posting a video every single day until further notice. So if you guys have any video requests, I would love for you to request them down below. And I'll definitely start filming them. I'm filming like 3 videos a day. So me filming a video doesn't cost me anything. And as long as I get to make you guys happy and you're giving me the opportunity to provide some great content, that's all that matters. Everything will be linked down below. My Instagram is Sergio Secrets. Make sure to follow me. And yeah, thank you so much for watching my videos. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye, guys.